I'd like to see King Kong Bundy do some of those things.
Are you kidding? This bout is scheduled for one fall. Introducing in the corner to my right, from Dallas, Texas, weighing 250 pounds, Scott Casey. The opponent, due to the incident of the area, accompanied by his manager, E. Lindemann, from Sarasota, Florida, weighing 238 pounds, Randy Macho Man Savage.
They're on their feet here in unison to welcome and greet the Macho Man Randy Savage and, of course, the lovely Elizabeth, and she is exceptionally lovely.
Something's happening to Savage. Week after week, he wants the title, and he's becoming vicious. He's becoming hungry. He can smell it.
Well, I've said it on a number of occasions, Brain, that it's just a question of time until some kind of gold is around the waist of that gentleman right there.
Well, he had it once, and he blew it.
Well, it was taken from him. Let's put it
but down. Now we got a good Intercontinental Champion, don't we?
Oh,
now
great.
You can look up to
him. Give me a break. I understand there was a couple of Humphrey Burgers in the locker room after that.
And you missed them?
Yeah, I left them for you. One of the premier athletes in all of professional sports today, the Macho Man, Randy Savage. And Elizabeth is indeed a lovely individual.
Yeah, but she could do better.
Who?
Elizabeth, please. She's a very, very attractive lady.
He's
a very talented athlete.
Scott Casey, not any slouch inside that squared circle. A real ring veteran.
But he's in Texas.
What's wrong with that?
Well, I think it's
something against Texas, too?
No, but I think it's in the water. None of them are real bright.
Oh, please. I'll have to mention that to Ron Bass when I see him, that you said that.
But there are exceptions.
Oh, yeah. Oh, scoop slam by Casey. Macho Man comes out the back door.
Fast count. That was a very bad count. That's the kind of a count I received at WrestleMania 3.
You want to talk about that?
No, I'm talking about the match.
Macho Man getting a mixture of boos and cheers here. Oh, look at him. Give me a break.
Why did Elizabeth jump in front of him?
Elizabeth did not jump in front of him. He literally pulled Elizabeth right in front of him so that Scott Casey couldn't get at him. Small package could be a big upset now.
I think that's what they'd like me to think. Elizabeth has
blind.
Hello, Elizabeth has more to this scene than you think.
Scott Casey doing everything in his power to put the guy away. It just ran into a very stiff elbow by the former Intercontinental Champion. Nice block of the right hand and delivers one of his own. Well, I'm very pleased with the way this Scott Casey has come along.
The Bulldog.
Bulldog coming up. Oh, he got nailed. He got crouched right on the second turnbuckle.
Well, when you go for the Bulldog, you get the horn. Or something like that.
Yeah. Look at this. Macho going to the top. That's from 18 feet high. Right down with a double axe handle. Right to the back of the net to Scott Casey. Could be the beginning of the end. As Macho's going up again. All these high risk moves. One of these days, he's going to make a big mistake. But wow! Planted the elbow. Goodbye. They're on their feet once again as the Macho Man chalking up another victory.
The winner of this bout, Randy Macho Man Savage.
The Macho Man Randy Savage raising his own hand in a token of victory. There's one of the many Macho Dolls around. Looks just like a dummy.
Pardon?
Forget about it. Right now, let's go back and take a look at the Macho Man perched high, all the way down, bounce away. Beautiful shot. If you miss with that one, it'll be all over. And there's the patented flying elbow. Plants it right in there, hooks the leg, just for good measure. Right now, let's go to my colleague, Greg DeGeorge, along with the Colonel, the Mountain of South, Jimmy Hart.